A clear understanding of what effective teaching looks like for a given school's context and priorities is essential to improving teaching and learning. Professional learning and development that promotes a clear understanding of effective teaching will be more impactful when it uses the Australian Professional Standards for Teachers as the basis for a common language, as well as a reference for goal setting and observation. It will have a greater impact when feedback and data is used to determine the effectiveness of teaching strategies. There is reflection on teaching practice, and when teachers are supported by coaching and mentoring processes. The two examples that follow feature examples of professional learning and development that include characteristics of a focus on effective teaching.
Once the national standards came in, the REAP process, which was that beginning of year goal setting exercise, was for personal and professional development, and every year we've enhanced it, and then we started to link them to the professional standards.
Every single teacher works with an instructional coach throughout the year, and the vast majority of teachers this year have voluntarily opted to use video as a really powerful reflection tool to evaluate their teaching practice, to ascertain whether they've been realising their goals, and also to get a really clear picture of the current reality of what's actually happening in their classroom.
Teachers who set their goals at the beginning of the year, they might identify that there are particular parts of their practice that they've aligned to the particular descriptors in the AITSL framework. They think that those are the things in their repertoire that they think might need a bit of a brush up and need to be enhanced. But when you're using video, very different things begin to emerge. Those things that you thought were perhaps areas for development could be revealed to be real strengths. And other things that weren't on your radar at all are things that you might discuss with your coach, and those are the ongoing target areas.
The whole purpose of recording a lesson is to have that rare opportunity to look at yourself, often from the perspective of one of your students.
Teachers are valuing the prospect of working with their colleagues, observing their colleagues and being observed, and finding out what great teachers in our school are doing.
This process was about giving evidence-based, targeted feedback to teachers. It followed the AITSL standards, our teaching model of E5, and then our own theories of action that were developed with David Hopkins in 2010.
It became pretty clear early on through reading research and through our own practice that classroom observations was the way forward, and that giving feedback that directly came from those observations meant that our feedback was no longer generalised in nature, that it was specific to what we do every day. We've developed theories of action that look at what teachers say and do and how that can effectively improve and influence student outcomes. So I feel that for my practice, considering those theories of action, I'm really able to, I guess, quantify what it is that an effective teacher says and does.
It's probably been one of the most powerful tools to get all the teachers to have the same language, the same understanding of what makes great teaching and learning.
Professional learning and development that focuses on effective teaching is more likely to have a positive impact when it is supported by a strong culture of professional learning and performance and development. A strong learning culture is evident in these examples through a sense of professional accountability and a responsibility to understand and to be the most effective teacher possible. A collegial and positive learning and development culture that is high in mutual trust. A commitment to gathering and using multiple sources of rich evidence. And a focus on student outcomes and engagement of students in professional learning and development.